In this tutorial, I'll teach you all about motion tracking. Using motion tracking allows you to track different objects in order to add a moving title, image or even blur or sensor faces or other information. In this video, we'll track a vehicle driving past a lake and add a graphic over top of it. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here, you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along. Let's get started. I have VideoStudio opened up under the Edit tab, and I'm going to drag the video of the traveling vehicle onto the video track on my timeline. Then, with my clip selected, I'll click on the Track Motion icon from the toolbar. A dialog box will pop up giving you some information on how to use this feature. The first step shows you that you can drag this red tracker to a point or area that you want to track. And the second step points towards this green box that you can place where you want to add a matched object, such as a title, graphic, or video. The third step is the Track Motion button, which we'll get into later. So I'm going to go ahead and drag this red tracker on top of the vehicle that I want to track. As I do this, you'll see a little magnifying window pops up to help me see exactly where I'm placing my tracker. You can select from three different tracker types. The default tracker is Set Tracker as Point, allowing you to pinpoint a position to track. The next one is Set Tracker as Area. And finally, there is Set Multipoint Tracker, which is used as a method to blur or censor objects. I'm going to select Set Tracker as Area for this video. And now I can click and drag the area box over the vehicle and adjust the nodes so it fits nicely over the van window. I'm also going to adjust this green box, which is going to act as a placeholder for where I want to replace it with a graphic later on. The green box will match the motion tracked by our tracker as well. Here you can uncheck the option to add a matched object or check it. You can also adjust the position from different preset options or choose custom to place it wherever you'd like. And on the preview window, you can adjust the nodes of the green box to adjust the size of the placeholder. Now let's say I don't want to track the van through the entire clip and just want to track a section of it. I can drag the scrubber to the starting point where I want to start the tracking and click Track In. And then drag the scrubber to where I want to finish tracking and click Track Out. Now let's click on the Track Motion button to track the motion of our vehicle. And you'll see that the box follows the van as it's moving. Once it has finished tracking, you can click on the Show Tracking Path icon to see the path you've created. And drag your scrubber along the timeline to see the path movement as well. If you want to reset the path you've just created, just click on the Reset to Default Position button. At the bottom, you can click the plus icon to add a new tracker, or the minus button to remove a tracker. You can also rename the tracker you've just created, and you can even click Save to Path Library to save the motion you've just tracked if you want to use it in future projects. Once you're happy with the motion you've tracked, click OK. You'll see that the placeholder is now on the overlay track on the timeline in the section of the clip that we just tracked. From here, you can right-click on the placeholder and select Replace Clip, and choose either video or photo. Another option is to browse in your library and find the media you want to add to replace the placeholder. Then drag it on top of the placeholder and press Ctrl on your keyboard before releasing. As you can see, this will replace the placeholder with our new graphic. And if we press play to preview, you'll see how the graphic follows alongside our van as it drives down the road. Finally, let's go to the Transitions tab and choose a soft transition like Dissolve and drag it to both the beginning and end of the overlay. Now if we preview this, you'll see the overlay has a soft fade in and fade out as it moves across the screen. These are just some of the ways you can use motion tracking to enhance your videos in a creative way. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along and find other helpful tutorials for VideoStudio.